Hello again, everyone. I'm WDSU sports anchor Fletcher Mackel, and we've got lots to talk about. LSU, Saints, and Pelicans, so let's just get right to it. We start with the shocking news of the day. Tiger star wide receiver Ja'Marr Chase has opted out of the 2020 season. A product of Archbishop Rummel High School in Metairie, Chase won the famed Biletnikoff Award in 2019. The award goes to college football's top college wide receiver. Ja'Marr Chase was a projected top five pick in the 2021 NFL draft. And Mike Dettillier, the draft analyst, says he won't be affected by sitting out the season. But how will the LSU Tigers be affected by losing a top wide receiver?
The guy that's going to really get hurt with this is Miles Brennan, a young quarterback. And on third and eight, I know Ja'Marr could get open. He would beat that coverage, and he was a big play artist. He's going to be affected by this more than anyone. What it gives an opportunity to is Racy McMath, because Terrace Marshall Jr. now becomes the guy that I rotate my coverage toward every time he hits the field. Because when Terrace has been healthy, he's been a really good football player at LSU. Racy becomes the guy now. That this is his great opportunity. The other part of it is how LSU is going to use their tight ends. They have the unicorn in Arik Gilbert. There is nobody that has hit LSU's campus at tight end like him. But the guy this really opens up the door for is twofold here: Racy McMath, Arik Gilbert.
Miles Brennan and the rest of the receivers and tight ends will have until September 26th when they open the season at home against Mississippi State to find a rhythm without Ja'Marr Chase. Now let's talk about the New Orleans Saints. On Sunday, we learned that backup running back Dwayne Washington has been placed on the league's COVID-19 reserve list. That means he's either tested positive for the coronavirus or he's been in direct contact with someone who has. Now, it is worth noting that the Saints have had three players prior to Washington end up on the same list, but all of their tests were false positives, so they came off within a few days. We also asked Saints defensive coordinator Dennis Allen, what happens if a coach gets COVID-19? Does the team have a plan in place specifically if he can't coach the defense or someone like Sean Payton can't oversee the offense?
Well, look, we've had those discussions, and we're just going to kind of keep that in house in terms of what our actual plans are and how we would go about doing that. But we do have a plan if that was the case, and certainly I hope you're not being the jinx to me.
I'm sorry.
I hope we don't have to deal with that. But if we do, we do have a contingency plan ready.
The Saints open the highly anticipated 2020 season 2 weeks from today at home in the Dome against Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And we close with the New Orleans Pelicans. The Pels are, of course, looking for a head coach after firing Alvin Gentry 2 weeks ago. I caught up with Pelicans analyst Nancy Lieberman, and I asked her, how good is this job?
I think it's one of the best jobs in the NBA, to be quite honest. It's a blank canvas of where you can go with incredible athletes who are next generation athletes.
Now realize that Nancy Lieberman is in the Pro Basketball Hall of Fame. She's a WNBA legend. She's also a former assistant coach with the Sacramento Kings and a head coach of the Dallas Mavericks G League team. So I just asked her, if David Griffin calls her and asks, is she interested in this job, what would her answer be?
Yes. Of course. I mean, it would be such an honor, whether it was me or anybody else. Like I just said, we love this game. And the greatest respect you could have is somebody saying, we're interested in sitting down and talking to you. You know, coaching in the NBA for women, it's not Skittles. Everybody doesn't get one. You have to earn the right. You have to build relationships. You have to be a lifer and a grinder in this game that we love. I mean, that's who I am. That's who Becky is. That's who Ginny Boo is. That's who Spoon is. Swing Cash. And shoot, David's been on the forefront of that by hiring those two incredible women.
Becky, who Lieberman references, is Spurs assistant Becky Hammond. She is widely regarded as the leading candidate to become the first female head coach in NBA history. And that's a look at sports reporting from my home. I'm Fletcher Mackel, WDSU News.